Hello everyone and welcome to another Magic Online video. I'm about to play a sealed PPTQ on Magic Online, so our pool should be popping up here any minute now. And I'm going to run through in 20 minutes or less, because we have 20 minutes to submit a deck, how I would build this pool. So this one's going to be a lot more on the fly than some of the other ones I've done. So let's sort by rarity here. We have a Thought Knot, it's a good rare. We have a Vile Redeemer, which is a decent card in green. It's not really a pull to play green, but it's a very good card if you're playing it. Oath of Gideon and Lantern Scout are both role players in white. Hissing Quagmire if we play red-green. And then a Gruesome Slaughter if we have a really good colorless deck, but it's unlikely that we'll play that. So let's go back to sorting by color. And then I'm going to start pulling out some of the cards from each color that are really good. So right off the bat, it looks like white is very deep. There's a lot of white cards, and it also looks like white's very good. So there's a good chance we play white. White's deep and powerful. I've already pulled out 14 cards I would consider good in white, and that's not even taking into account all these other playables that are still in here. So white looks good. If we look at blue, let's see, we have two Avengers, Incubator Drone, Sweep Away Sky Spawner, Containment Membrane, and Prophet. So blue is pretty strong as well, and if you also look here, we're already at 22 playables, so with white being as deep as it is, maybe like Unified Front, only if we're playing like a three-color deck, but with white as deep as it is, our other color doesn't have to be that deep to pair with it. And I know it's weird to just automatically assume that I'm going to be playing white, but it just seems like white is definitely a pretty good bet. All right, let's look at black. Black, we have some good stuff here. Natural Endurance is fine. So black, we have like a Zulaport Chain Mage, and a Vampire Envoy, and a Clastry Healer that go well with white. But black kind of suffers from a weird identity in this set where half of it's these colorless cards like Sludge Crawler, Slaughter Drone, Shrieker, and the other half's these random allies. So I think black is okay, maybe on the same power level as blue, but ultimately not great. If we look at red here, so red, and one thing that our white is lacking is great removal. So we have a Sheer Drop and an Oath of Gideon, or a Sheer Drop and a Gideon's Reproach as are really our only removal spell. So white is a little shy on removal, so this Touch of the Void is nice to have for red, as well as these Reality Hemorrhages and an Outnumber. So red looks pretty good here. I could really see pairing red with white. We would also get Weapons Trainer if we did. Let's look at green. We have two Brood Monitors, the Vile Redeemer. Green has a couple of good cards, but it's really shallow, so I think I can safely say that I'm just off of green. Now if we look at our colorless cards here, we have a Thought Knot, we have a Warden of Geometries. We're not going to be playing the Gruesome Slaughter, probably not the Despoiler. It's just a 5/5 for 6 without a lot of great exiling cards. And then Ruin Processor is pretty good and might make the cut depending on what we're playing. And then let's look at our mana here. So we have, let's look at some of these lands. There is a Timber Gorge and a Cinder Barrens, which help us if we're playing a red deck splashing another color, and a Quagmire. So we have a lot of cards that do that. Then we have a Crumbling Vestige and a Blighted Woodland. So we actually have a lot of good mana fixing too, which is nice. I don't want to play more than a two-color deck because our white's so powerful and we don't need to play more than two colors, but it is nice to know that our mana is going to support playing this Thought Knot Seer. So now I want to lay things out and see what things look like. And ultimately, I'm probably going to play either white-blue or white-red. I could also play white-black, but it's going to really depend on how things look like when I lay it out. I'm going to start with white-red. So sort by mana cost, and I also like to group creatures separately, so that way we see our spells below our creatures. And let's see, we have a weapons trainer as well. It's another one to get in there. There's a thought knot, a ruin processor, a warden of geometries. And then white red only gets us a couple colorless lands, really. So, let's see. Looking at white red here, we have a little bit of decent ally theme. Some good creatures. White red has a lot of good creatures, and then we have a lot, like a plethora of removal spells here. We also have an Oath of Gideon, which doesn't seem particularly great, but could be played. So I would say that white red looks good. I think white red actually looks pretty good. So that's something to say is, yeah, I think white red looks good. Let's go ahead and take a look at. Let's remove these red cards. Let's take a look at white-blue. See what that looks like. So I'm just going to put these in the same spot so I can easily get back to them. So white-blue was Prophet of Distortion down. Let's do the same thing again here where we group creatures separately. Sort by mana cost. Okay, so white-blue has a lot less spells. We have the Reproach, the Sheer Drop, and just a couple of things. We also get, we do get two more removal spells, which is nice. And now let's look at the creature base here. We get a Prophet, a Sky Spawner, Cultivator Drone, an Incubator Drone. So I would say that blue-white looks pretty good, actually. We have really like four removal spells. And we probably would not play Oath of Gideon here because we don't really need it for the ally theme. And we have so many 3-drops as well, so we probably just play like these 23 cards. But I will say that I think that blue-white looks pretty good. So we could also play Searing Light, maybe Tandem Tactics as well. Tandem Tactics doesn't seem too bad. We could cut something, you know, maybe cut the Warden of Geometries or cut the Ruin, maybe the Ruin Processor just doesn't have a place in this deck. Regardless, I think blue-white looks good, and I also think it looks better than white-red. So I just want to pull the white-red again just to compare. But I think that this blue-white deck looks a little bit better. And it has more flying creatures too, which is which I do like. Alright, let's pull the white-red back in. The white-red does have great removal, though. Alright, so sort by converted mana cost and group separately again. Alright, so now let's think about how this white-red compares. We have more removal spells, but Reality Hemorrhage is pretty medium. We wouldn't want to play the Searing Light if we were playing white-red. Because we have these hemorrhages that do the same thing, basically. We probably wouldn't want to play the Tandem Tactics either. Maybe we would want one. Huh. This is actually really close. We might skip out on either the Warden. I guess there's still that big guy, Ruin Processor. We might skip out on Vestige of Emrakul. It doesn't really have any synergy with our deck, but it is a nice creature. And I'd probably skip out on like one Reality Hemorrhage. So this looks like a pretty good white-red deck as well. And actually, I think it's a really, really tough call as to which deck is better. Let's go ahead and lay out the... I want to try laying black out, but it's hard to imagine that black is going to be better than... what we've seen from either of these two colors, but let's go ahead and do it. I still have 10 minutes left, so I'm not under a lot of time pressure. I'd be very happy registering either the white-red or the white-blue deck. Let's go ahead and pull out the red. Or the black. Alright, so... And we get these unnatural endurances. Yeah, so let's group separately and sort by mana cost. Now let's see what this looks like. So, Yeah, we have less removal. We're not really adding that much power. This isn't that powerful in our deck. This isn't that powerful in our deck. So I just want to say right now that it's very clear to me that this black is worse. These cards are all of medium power level. We're not really boosting the power of our deck. We're just filling it in. So let's go ahead and get these black cards out of here. And then let's go back to the blue again. I think I kind of like the blue deck the best, but maybe I'm just biased because I really like cards like Prophet of Distortion. Blue deck just also has these two flyers, which are really big, and Sky Spawner, which is big. Just has a lot of flying creatures. We have the Sky Climber, the Sky Spawner, and we have the two Avengers, the Expedition Raptor, Angel of Renewal. Just really looks like a good flyer deck. We have basically three ways to remove creatures. We're a little lacking in the early game. So there is that. I don't think it's a huge issue though. Let's look at, so if we wanted to build this blue-white deck, we would, let's see, we'd probably play the Searing Light. Maybe not. Maybe we don't main deck that card. Tandem Tactics. That actually doesn't sound like that great either. Basically, I could see us cutting a 3-drop. I think our worst one is Core Scythe Master. But I do like its ability to attack, and it is very good with Relief Captain and Expedition Raptor. So I think I'm actually... We also want a lot of creatures because we have like Angel Renewal and these two support cards. So... Also, allies are good with Spawnbinder Mage, Ondu War Cleric, and Lantern Scout. So, I think I would register this. Maybe we don't want Ruin Processor. We don't have any way to exile, do we? Thought Not Seer. We only have one way to exile. I do like the 7-8 body. So, I think I would start this. So, I think I would actually just start this deck here. So let's go ahead and add our lands in. So we want to play the Vestige, the Unknown Shores, and the Waste. Maybe the Woodland. I mean, the Woodland is the same as the Wastes, really. But I don't think... There's no really drawback to playing Woodland over Wastes. I guess there's no upside to Woodland, though. So we'll just play the Wastes. And let's see, we have the Prophet and the Thought Knot are really our only cards that need colorless. So I think I'm okay with just having these. In fact, we maybe don't even need the Wastes. But our mana requirements are pretty light. So let's go ahead and add lands. I think it should just be 7 and 7. It's telling us 8 and 6. Let's actually do 8 and 7. And I'm actually going to cut the Wastes. So that leaves us with only two lands for Prophet and Thought Knot, but we also have Warden of Geometries, Cultivator Drone, Sky Spawner, and Incubator Drone, so I think we'd still be able to cast these cards a decent amount of time. Yeah, I like this deck, so I'm going to go ahead and submit this as our deck. And then I'm going to... Is it Export to Collection? Okay. I'm just going to name this Blue-White. And then let's build the Blue-Red deck too. Let's get rid of these islands. Alright. Ten lands. I get one more card here. 17 creatures. I like the tandem tactics more in this deck because we have a lot more creatures. So I think I want to play the tandem tactics. Oh man, this deck's really good as well. I'm not sure which is a more powerful deck. This deck also has a lot of creatures. Zada's Command is very, very good. Has good removal. Outnumber Touch the Void. Has this press. I guess I could have been I could play one Reality Hemorrhage, but I think I like the tandem tactics over it. No, maybe not. So the white red deck, though, we still have the Thought Knot Seer. Maybe we just don't play Thought Knot in the white red version, since it's going to be harder to cast. If we cut Thought Knot Seer, I can play Vestige of Emrakul. That feels better to me. Then we don't have to play these lands. We don't have to play these lands, which they aren't very great if you're not trying to utilize them. So we have 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 planes. We probably want to have like 9 planes, 8 mountains, 17 lands. Okay. So then this is a pretty good white-red deck. I'm trying to think of situations where... I think situations where this deck's better are where we need more removal spells, like hard removal, and we don't care that much about flying creatures, don't matter as much. And I think the blue-white deck's better when we care about flying creatures. Let's export this deck as well as white-red. See if I can. What can I load? Okay, cool. Wait, blue light 2. What's that? Okay, that's the blue white deck. This blue white deck does have a worse curve than the white red deck. It's pretty glutted at 3. 3 mana. It does get to play more powerful cards, though. Sky Spawner, the 2 flyers, the Thought Knot Seer. So. Yeah, I think I'm going to go with this blue-white deck. But I can switch into the white-red deck, and I'll probably do that, actually. I'll probably just alternate almost every round just to see which is starting to play better. But I do have to start... I do have to pick a deck that I'm always going to start with because this is a sealed PPTQ, so you have to pick a deck to always start with. Oh, man. Tough call. You know what? I kind of actually want to... I kind of want to just start with this deck. I think this is just a better deck. So, yeah, I'm going to start with this white-red deck, and then we get to switch into the white-blue deck whenever we feel that it's better. So, we'll play the white-red deck, and we'll see how that goes. Thanks for watching the Sealed Building. Hopefully it was informative. And make sure you stay tuned, because I'll be playing some amount of rounds of this deck in the event itself.